Welcome back, boys and girls. Welcome back to Just Shake or Steer. My name is George, and yet another cocktail day. So today we're going back to the 80s, and I'm gonna prepare for you a classic, which it's born in the 80s, and it's a fantastic, again, easy, straightforward cocktail. Many of you probably have it, but today I wanna prepare two versions, the original one, and of course, the variation, which I like to make for myself. So the cocktail which I talk about and which I refer to, it's the world famous Bramble. It's a modern classic, or not that modern anymore because it's from the 80s. But anyway, it's created by Dick Bradsell from the Fred's Club in Soho, London, back in the 80s. And his words, he wanted to create something which it's truly British. But then he say it can be truly British because obviously, apart from the gin, Crème de Mûre, nothing to do with England, or neither the lemons, okay, because that time they was coming from Spain or whatever else. Anyway, he kind of a play with it, he tried a few things until we came to the proper recipe of the Bramble. It's a basically, you may say it's a gin sour, but a little bit on the fruity side with the Bramble. Whatever you want to say, it's a wonderful cocktail, and many people associate the cocktail with a spring. However, you can drink any time of the year. As far as you like gin and you like soury or sweet and sour, let's say, taste, and you fancy something refreshing, it doesn't matter which season you drink it. Okay? So, today I'm gonna make, as I mentioned, the original classic by Dick Bradsell, and I'm gonna make my own version. And you decide which one you want to try or which one probably it's more to your taste. So, if you're ready, boys and girls, let's make the Bramble two ways. Okay, so let's make the original recipe first of all. We need our ingredients, so we need gin. I'm going with a London Dry. This is a 50 pound gin, fantastic London Dry gin. Use whatever it's your favorite gin, okay? As far as it's not flavored, yeah? It needs to be London Dry. Then Crème de Mûre liqueur. We're gonna need some sugar syrup and of course, freshly squeezed lemon. Now, the original cocktail, it's served over crushed ice, but first of all, it's shaken. So we're gonna start, first of all, with our lemon. We need 30 ml of our lemon. So I'm gonna do a freshly squeezed lemon juice. Of course, feel free to squeeze it in advance, but use freshly squeezed lemon juice. So I'm gonna go with 30 ml. Nearly there, I have really big lemons this time, and half of it, it's just touching the line of 30 ml, okay? Wonderful. I need my mat here so we don't make mess. Then we're gonna go with the gin. Now the original recipe, it's required 2 shots of gin. We will go with 30 ml, which is 1 ounce, okay, not 25. Just so it's easy for everyone. So we're gonna do with 2 shots, 30 ml, which is 1 ounce. Obviously, this is make 2 ounces of your gin. Beautiful. Then just half an ounce or 15 ml of sugar syrup. Simple sugar syrup. And finally, we need Crème de Mûre, but this is gonna come on the end, and you'll see why. I hope you had Bramble in your life, but if you didn't, you'll see why the Crème de Mûre is not going in the shaker. Okay, we need ice. Right. Give it a good shake, and we'll serve. Wonderful. Now, if you can like freeze your glass or chill it out, it'll be fantastic. But if you don't, it's fine because we're gonna serve over crushed ice. However, I have mine in the freezer ready. So I'm gonna grab it and I'm gonna fill it up with some crushed ice. There you go. Wonderful. and let's strain. So strain over the crushed ice your cocktail. Beautiful. And around 12 and a half or 15 ml of crème de mûre on the top, just to float. Obviously it's gonna drop down, but that's the idea when you're serving. So it's just drizzle on the top. And there you have it. A garnish, a lovely, fantastic blackberry. And you can put a slice of lemon if you want, or slice of lime, or whatever you decide. In this case, I'm just gonna leave it as it is, and I'm just gonna put it on the side, and we're gonna make my version soon I clean up. Okay, I'm back, everything is ready. I have the original version here, and now I'm gonna make my own. So, nothing pretty much changed, except that I'm gonna introduce a fresh blackberry to the mix, okay? And it's gonna be served on a large cube of clear ice instead of be serving on crushed ice. That's all it is. The rest of it, it's pretty much the same, okay? So 2 shots of the gin, which is 60 ml or 2 ounces. Okay. Now I'm gonna take my small tin and I'm gonna drop inside a 4 nice ripe blackberries, okay? Now here it is, the whole difference. 15 ml or 1/2 ounce of the crème de mûre going inside with the actual blackberries. And we're gonna muddle it, okay? We're gonna release the juices from these lovely blackberries. Now they need to be ripe, okay? Don't get any like a green one. They need to be nice and juicy, very important. 15 ml or 1/2 ounce of the sugar syrup, go to your gin. Keep the shaker with your blackberries on the side. You can muddle everything first in the big one and then add the rest of the ingredients. I'm just used to it to do it this way. It doesn't really matter. And finally, 1/2 lemon. Squeezed inside directly. So as you can see here, I'm not layering or not putting the crème de mûre after. Everything is shaken together. And it's gonna be served again in a nice chilled glass, but just over a clear ice. There you go. Let's give it a shake. Absolutely fantastic. I need a little cleanup. Clean bar, happy bar. Okay, next glass. Now again, I have a frozen glass and I have this lovely, nice cube of clear ice. We're gonna do double straining here because obviously we have the blackberries inside and we don't want them in the mix. We just want the actual cocktail. And there you go, boys and girls. Quite different color because obviously we have fresh fruit inside and it's gonna release the juice plus the actual liqueur. So it's gonna be like a nice dark and purple, nearly black. But this is how I like to make my bramble, okay? This is a reef, obviously, so I don't know. We can still call it bramble, I presume. I hope so. Now just a nice cocktail pick. I'm just gonna drop a blackberry on the side and there you have it. This is my version of the Bramble. So it's up to you to decide which one you want to try. Or you may want to try both of them. Okay? So let's give it a sip from the first one. That's the original. There's no surprise here. I love this, the original version. It's a wonderful refreshing, fruity, like I want to call it, gin sour, but it's not exactly, but it is. I don't know, it's fantastic. You have the lovely lemon, you have the lovely, a tiny touch of creme de mûre, like the, you know, I mean, the fruity flavor. You can still feel the gin. It's a fantastic cocktail, and not surprised it's associated with spring because it's really refreshing. But I can have any time of the year, okay? And let's have mine now. Not much difference, except it's more on the fruity side because you have fresh blackberries muddler inside and you release the juice, and obviously you have more intense flavor of the blackberries. However, it doesn't overpower the gin, it doesn't overpower the lemon juice, and with the help of the simple sugar syrup, you have this lovely, wonderful balance of all the ingredients. So whichever you choose, it'll be a fantastic sip, I promise you. So this is it, boys and girls. I'll see you next week. Don't forget, if you're new to the channel, you know the drill, what to do. Hit this like button, maybe subscribe if you wish, and leave me a comment. Don't be shy. And I'll see you next week. Until then, as always, I love you and I leave you. Bye-bye.